gang. Travis Fogle cut. John Hightower out of there. JJ Arthego Whiteside still blocking the sun. Surprise makes and some surprise cuts of the day. Philadelphia Eagles 53 man is here. Let's go and get it, gang. Notion gang, salute. You already know, let's check the phone. Okay, hold on. Lambo, check, hold up, ring, check. We all the way in there, gang. Y'all already know, if y'all do, subscribe. Y'all know what to do, go hit that subscribe. And activate that notification bell just so you live with all the Notion. We like 3 days away until Notion's official $100 giveaway. So y'all already know the vibes. Check the video I dropped for the $100 gift card on rules on how to enter. So without further ado, gang, the 53-man roster has been sent, and there's been a lot of shocking cuts and some shocking makes, if you ask me. First shocking cut on this list definitely has to be Travis Fogle. Listen, this man was our leading wide receiver last year on this team. Whatever happened between then and now and in preseason, I don't know, but evidently he didn't do enough to impress this coaching staff. Hopefully he goes unclaimed so we could possibly maybe put him on our practice squad. But evidently he didn't do enough between, in preseason, between the preseason games. He didn't show this coaching staff enough. Maybe it was the hands, I don't know. But for whatever reason, this man got cut and now he's subject to the waiver wire. So hopefully we sign him back, because again, I believe in Travis Fogle. I believe he would have added more of some value to this team than another wide receiver we signed. But we're going to get into that in a moment. Another shocking cut on this list would definitely be John Hightower. Now, we just drafted John Hightower last year with a fifth-round pick. Evidently, again, maybe the team thinks he's a one-trick pony. The speed is definitely evident with John Hightower, but he had some problems with his route running and, of course, bringing the ball in at times. So, evidently, the team got tired of that, got rid of John Hightower. I would have thought that we could at least maybe develop John Hightower, but apparently this team is putting their resources in developing other talent not named John Hightower. So, John Hightower is not on this 53-man roster. Hopefully, he comes back and we can claim him on the practice squad. Another shocking cut that's not a wide receiver definitely would be Jordan Howard. Now, Jordan Howard's interesting. Hey, in my opinion, I thought he was the best blocking running back on the team. He could have been utilized in short goal line situations or anytime we needed short yardage. But I'm assuming that this team, they value hands, because every other running back that we did keep, which is a little concerning to me, we're only keeping three, but they all got hands and they can catch out of the backfield. Maybe that's what, pretty much stopped Jordan Howard from making this team. Maybe he clears waivers and we could also put him on our practice squad. But that definitely was shocking to me. But that's only keeping three running backs. We definitely going light in that department, but I believe we can still get the job done. So I'm not too overly concerned, but I was definitely shocked. So lastly, of course, JJ Arthego Whiteside makes the team. Congratulations. Hey, I'm going to tell y'all right now, y'all know how I was roasting this man in the offseason, but I got to change my tune now. Hey, welcome to the official squad, JJ. I hope you bring some production this year, because definitely I don't want to just see it in the preseason. I want to see it in the actual game when it counts. And for the past years that we've had JJ, we haven't seen it. But at the same time, this team must have saw something in JJ to keep him over the likes of Fogle and Hightower. So I gotta congratulate JJ. I'm done with the JJ joke. Until you, Bring me some more reason to bust out the joke book, JJ, because please believe I will take it there, brother. But at the same time, congratulations to JJ for working hard and making this team. With that being said, I got a special announcement, gang. So listen, gang, if by mid-season, so we'll say week 8, if for whatever reason JJ Arcega-Whiteside is leading our team in touchdown catches, because we all know he ain't going to lead the team in no receiving yards, so I ain't even going to do y'all like that. We're going to make it realistic. So if he's leading our team with touchdown catches by week 8, I'm purchasing somebody a JJ Arcega-Whiteside jersey. We're going to do it as a giveaway, so I'm putting it on tape right now that if that's the case, somebody's getting a JJ jersey. So I'm pulling for JJ. I hope for some production, and we're going to leave it at that, gang. So, hey, y'all let me know y'all thoughts in the comments below. Who were some of your surprise cuts? Who was a surprise make for y'all? Let me know in the comments below. Also, hey, will JJ have some production this year? Y'all let me know that down below. But, hey, gang, at the end of the day, this 53-man roster is built. We all in with this team less than 2 weeks away until official game day. Yes, sir. So, hey, it's always fly, Eagles, fly. And y'all already know the vibes. And until next time, y'all know what it is.